Of all the laws that we're discussing now, the laws we're about to cover, workers' compensation insurance requirements and unemployment insurance requirements, are among the most heavily regulated and enforced requirements that the Department of Labor administers. We often get notice from farmers who have received a questionnaire or a letter that lists questions they have to answer from the Department of Labor, questioning the status of their workers, who they may be classifying and generally are classifying as independent contractors, hoping for that exemption from workers' compensation and unemployment insurance requirements. Well, these questions ask essentially the same questions that you'll find in the independent contractor seven-part test, asking if they own their own tools, if they're closely supervised, part of the same organization, those kinds of questions. These are the kinds of questions that you need to consider before you employ or, you know, use the services of any of these workers, because these are the questions that are going to be asked, and if you answer them right the first time before bringing on the worker, you're going to be in a lot better shape. So unemployment insurance requirements require you as an employer to file with the New Hampshire Department of Labor an employer status report, and this determines how much you need to pay to unemployment. Your premium, or how much you have to pay, depends on turnover of your employees. Now, exemptions exist for agricultural employers who pay less than $20,000 within a three-month period in the previous or the current calendar year, and have less than 10 different employees in 20, does not have to be consecutive, different weeks during the previous or current year. So it can be just 20 weeks where you had 10 or more employees within last year or this year.
Okay, so you have to write to the Department of Labor and they tell you the rate that you have to pay, that you have to pay, and it's really guided by turnover. An exemption to what? Having to have it?
Yeah.
Having to pay into it.
So why, if you have 10 different employees, why does the number of employees you have?
Well, it's the size of the farm. So if you have a payroll that's less than $20,000 within a three-month period, and you have less than 10 employees, you don't have to pay into unemployment insurance.
This exemption is designed to not be such a burden on a small farm that has employees. Mm-hmm. So if you fit within the exemption, you're a small farm, then you don't have to spend the money for unemployment insurance.
And if you have a question, you check with your attorney or
you can call your
the Department of Labor.
Exactly.
That's right.
Or you can have your attorney call the Department of Labor for you.